Today we are going to see about exercise number 3.5 part 1. Okay, before starting this exercise, first we should know about that some fundamentals. Okay, so today we are see about factorization. Okay. What do you mean by factorization? Factorization is nothing but it's a reverse of multiplication. Okay, so for example, we are taking the numbers 3 and 5. Okay, 3 and 5. What is the product? The product is 15. Okay, so if you are taking the reverse, what is that? If you are taking the number 15, the factors are. How can you split this 15? Factors are 3 and 5. Okay, so the factorization is nothing but it's a reverse of multiplication. Okay, in this factorization we have a two ways. Okay, we have a two ways. Okay, the first one is by taking common factor, by taking out common factor. Okay, by taking common factor. So first we should check any common elements or common variables are there or not. Okay, that you have to check first. Okay, for example, AB plus AC. Okay, AB plus AC. Here A is the common element. Okay, so if you taking A, B plus C. So here A and B plus C are the factors. Okay, so this is the first method. Then second one, by grouping the terms. Okay, by grouping the terms. By grouping the terms. Okay, we will see one example. Okay, I am taking this A plus B minus PA minus PB. Okay, so in this this is one group. Okay, in this one is a one group. Okay, so this is A plus B. From these two terms, okay, from these two terms I can take that P outside, minus P outside. So what do you get? This is minus PA. I can take out minus P, that means you can get the remaining term as A. Okay, so then here also you will get B. Okay, so now we can check here A plus B, here also A plus B. Okay, so now we can take out A plus B. Okay, so what are the remaining terms? If you are taking this term A plus B outside, the remaining is 1. Okay, remaining is 1. Okay, then here you will get P. So these are the factors. Okay, so like this you have to factorize in two ways. First one is by taking common factor, and another one is grouping them. Okay, then one more thing, suppose you are taking it is a quadratic polynomial. Okay, it is a quadratic polynomial. We know that the form of quadratic polynomial is okay, quadratic means it is a degree is 2. Okay, so it is a form of ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, so if you want to find the factors for this quadratic polynomial, we have to split into two ways. Okay, that is first sum of the terms and the product of the terms. Product of the terms means you will get, product means you can multiply this constant term and the coefficient of x square. So the product term is AC, okay, and the sum term is B. Okay, you have to take two numbers and you have to satisfy that two numbers should be satisfy these conditions. Okay, if you are taking any two numbers, that should be, if you multiply you will get this product term. Okay, if you multiply you will get this product term, if you add this you will get this sum term. Okay, I will explain with one example, you will understand clearly. Okay, so for example I can take this quadratic polynomial x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay, it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, so what is the product term? We know that here a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 5 and c is equal to 6. Okay, already I told you it's a product term is ac, product term is ac. So what do you get? 1 into 6 you will get 6. Okay, then sum term is b. Okay, sum term is b, this is product. Okay, this is product and sum term is b. Okay, so what is the b value? 5. Okay, so now you are going to choose any two numbers, that two numbers should be satisfied this conditions. If you multiply you will get 6, if you add you should get 5. Okay, so what are the numbers possibles? You can take it from 1. Okay, so 1 into 6 6, but if you are adding you will get 7, so this is not possible. Okay, then 2 3 2 3 means 2 3s are 6, if you multiply 2 3s are 6, if you add you will get 5. Okay, so this is the correct factors. So how can you split this? X square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to, these are the factors 2 and 3, so you can write as here the variable is 2, here the variable is x, so you can take it as x plus 2 into x plus 3. Okay, in this way you should solve the quadratic polynomial. Okay, then now we will start exercise number 3.5 part 1. Okay, so now we will start exercise 3.5 part 1. In this first question, question number exercise 3.5 question number 1. Okay, question number 1, factorize the following expression, factorize the following expressions. In this we have a two subdivisions, that first one is 2a square plus 4a square b, then plus 8a square c. Already I told you, if you want to factorize we have a two ways. First one is taking common factor and second one is grouping the terms. Okay, so first we should check any common factors are there or not. Okay, so in this we have a all the numbers 2 4 8, all the numbers are it's a multiples of 2. Okay, so we can take it out 2. Okay, then a also for common for the all the three terms, here a square, here also a square, then here also a square, so you can take it out 2a square. Okay, so what is the remaining terms? Here 2a square comes outside. Okay, so remaining term is only 1. Here 4a square, here the 4 is splitted into 2 into 2. Okay, so we can take it out 1, 2. So remaining 1, 2 is there. So you can take 2, a square comes out. So remaining b. Okay, then plus, here 8 is there. We can take it out 2. So therefore, it is factorize 2 into 4. Okay, so 2 already we can take out. So remaining 4 is there. Then a square is already take out, then remaining c. Okay, hereafter we can't able to factorize these terms. Okay, so this is your answer. So the answer is 2a square 1 plus 2b plus 4c. Okay, this is your answer. Then question number 1, second subdivision. Okay, in question number 2, second subdivision, the question is AB minus AC minus MB plus MC. Okay, so we know that we can use the second method, okay, that is grouping the terms. Here we can take it these two terms and these two terms. Okay, in this first two terms we have take out A. Okay, what are the remaining terms? B minus C. Okay, then next one, here we have a factor B minus C. That means the second term also we can take it as a multiple of B minus C. So here minus B is there, but in this first factor we have B plus B minus C. So here you can take minus M. Are you clear? If in this first two terms we can write as A into B minus C, but here in this term if you are taking only M, it will be minus B. Okay, but in this first term we have plus B minus C, so I can take it minus M outside. So remaining is B. This plus term will change it into minus because we can take it out minus M. Okay, so we know that here also B minus C, here also B minus C. That means you can take it B minus C outside. So what are the remaining terms? A minus M. Okay, this is your answer. Then question number 2. The first sum over. Okay, then question number 2. First one, first subdivision, the question is x square plus 4x plus 4. Okay, x square plus 4x plus 4. Okay, already I told you we can for quadratic polynomial we can split into two ways, that is product and sum. Okay, here the a value is 1, so 1 into 4 4 and the sum is 4. Okay, so you want to choose the two numbers, that two numbers if you multiply you will get 4, if you add also you will get 4. That means what are the numbers we can choose? 2 and 2. Okay, so 2 2's are 4, then 2 plus 2 also 4. Okay, so you can take it as x plus 2 into x plus 2. So we have a two terms same. Okay, so that therefore you will get x plus 2 whole square. This is your answer. Okay, then next second subdivision, the question is 3a square minus 24ab plus 48b square. Okay, so first step you have to check any common terms are there or not. Okay, if it is any, if you have any common terms, first you can take it out. So here what is the common term? In numbers, all the numbers are, it's a multiples of 3. So you can take 3 outside. Okay, any other common variable are there or not? Here a square, here a b, here b only. Okay, so we cannot take a common variable, only the number will be, we can take it out. So what is the remaining terms? A square minus in 24 we can split into 8 into 3. Okay, so we can take it out 3 outside. So remaining term is 8. ओके सो हियर 8 ओके देन एबी 8 एबी देन फॉर 48 वी कैन टेक इट 3 आउटसाइड सो द रिमेनिंग नंबर इज मल्टीपल नंबर इज 16 3 16s आर 48 ओके सो रिमेनिंग 16 बी स्क्वायर ओके इन दिस वी हैव a square minus 8ab plus 16b square. Okay, so how can you split this? We can use that method also. Already we told you, that method also we can use, or otherwise we can use the formula method. For example, 3a square, you can take it as a whole square. Okay, then last term, here 16b square. 16b square means 16 is the square number of 4. Okay, so 4b whole square. Okay, so here we have a negative symbol. So it is a form of a minus b whole square. We know that a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay, so in this format we can going to change. Okay, so here we want to minus 2. Okay, here already we can take a is a, so no problem, and b is the term of 4b. Okay, so once again you can check it, here 2 into 4 you will get 8, and a is there and b also is there, so we can split into this ways. So we know that it is a form of a minus b whole square. So here a is a, so a minus, here b is equal to 4b, so 4b and whole square. Okay, this is your answer. Then next, third subdivision, the question is x power 5 minus 16x, x power 5 minus 16x. X power 5 minus 16x. Okay, so here what is the common variable? X is the common variable, so you can take it outside. What is the remaining? Here x power 5, that means x has a multiple of 5 times. X is multiple by 5 times, so we can take it out one time. So remaining terms are x power 4. Okay, then next remaining, this x comes outside, so remaining term is 16. Okay, then next, here we have a power 4. Okay, so you can write as x. Okay, then this x is power 4, we can write as x square the whole square. Okay, 2 2s are 4, so I can split into x square whole square. Then like this you have to split the number 16 also. How can you split this? It is the 4 square. Okay, it is 4 square. Okay, so we know that the formula a square minus b square, a square minus b square, here a is equal to x square. Okay, here a is equal to x square, then b is equal to 4, b is equal to 4. So what is the form of a square minus b square? A plus b into a minus b. Okay, a plus b into a minus b. So you can apply it here. You can apply here. What do you get? X into, here a is a x square. So x square plus 4 and x square minus 4. Okay, then x square plus 4. This term we can't change. Okay, so the remaining term is x square minus 4. This term I can split into again the same way. It is a form of a square minus b square. So we can write as x square plus 4 into, this is written as x the whole square minus 2 the whole square. Okay, already we did the same process. Okay, the same way I can use here also. Okay, So again you can write as this is A, x is equal to A and 2 is equal to B. So again A square minus B square formula. So you can write as A plus B into A minus B. So this is x square plus 4. For addition we can't split the terms, okay. So that we have a formula A square minus B square only. So that only I can take this term alone, x square minus 4 alone I can split it again, okay. So what do you get here? A square minus B square means A plus B into A minus B. So you can write as x plus 2 into x minus 2, okay. So this is your answer. Then next, in second question, fourth subdivision, okay. Here each problem have a separate model, okay. So you can practice well, then only we can solve the sums easily, okay. M square by plus 1 by m square minus 23, okay. So we know that here we have a m square and 1 by m square, okay. So we are going to change this polynomial into square format, okay. But 23 is not a square number, so we should make it as a square number. So what we can do, first you can take it as m square plus 1 by m square, then 23 is not a square number. So we are going to make it as a square. So what is the nearest square number? We know that 25 is a square number. So if you add minus 2, it will make it as minus 25, okay. But we should not take it as directly, you should add minus 2. So what we can do, minus 23, we can add plus 2 and minus 2. Why we are adding plus 2 and minus 2? If you are adding plus 2 and minus 2, it will be 0, okay. So if you add like this, that variable cannot be, that expression cannot be changed. So that only we are taking plus 2 and minus 2, okay. So next step, m square plus 1 by m square. We know that this two terms, that minus 23 and minus 2, we can write as minus 25. Then plus, sorry, wait. This plus 2, then minus 25. Okay. See, if you want take these two terms, what is the form? A square plus B square plus 2AB here. A is equal to m and b is equal to 1 by m, okay. So if you apply a plus b whole square, what do you get? M square plus 1 by m square plus 2ab, that is m into 1 by m, okay. So what do you get? This m and numerator and denominator will be cancel. So what do you get? M square plus 1 by m square plus 2, okay. So this is the term we have already. So how can you write this? This is the form of a plus b whole square. So you can write as m plus 1 by m whole square. I hope you are clear. Then minus 25 is the square number. It is a square of 5, okay. So you can take it as 5 square, okay. So this is the form of a square minus b square. This is your a and this is your b, okay. Here a is equal to, again you can write, a is equal to m plus 1 by m and b is equal to 5, okay. If you have a form of a square minus b square, you can write as a plus b into a minus b. See here, m plus 1 by m the whole square minus 5 square. So I can take this m plus 1 by m as a and 5 is b. So it is a form of a square minus b square. So for this I can apply a square minus b square is equal to, already we know that it is a plus b into a minus b. Okay, a plus b into a minus b. So here my a is m plus 1 by m. So m plus 1 by m, here b is what, 5. So m plus 1 by m plus 5. M plus 1 by m plus 5 and again m plus 1 by m minus 5. Okay, this is your answer. Then next, question number 2, fifth subdivision. Question number 2, fifth subdivision. Okay, 6 minus 216 x square. Already we know that we can, if you have any common terms, we can take it outside. So 216 is factored as 6 into 6 into 6. Okay, 6 into 6 into 6. 36 into 6. 216. Okay, so if I take 6 outside, here I will get 1 minus, here I can take 1 6 outside. So what are the remaining terms? 36. Okay, so 36 x square. Okay, then 6, 36 is a square number, x also has a square, so I can take it as, this is 6 x the whole square. Okay, if you split it, 6 into 6 square 36, and x into x you will get x square. So I can write this term as 6x square. Then 1 also we have to make it as a square, so 1 square is 1, already we know that. So I can take it as 1 square. Why I can write for 1 also square? Because I want to use this formula, a square minus b square. A square minus b square is what? A plus b into a minus b. So for that, for a we need to square. So for that, 1 as written as 1 square. Okay, so 6, here a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 6x. Okay, a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 6x. So what do you get? The formula, a plus b into a minus b. So it can be written as 1 plus 6x and 1 minus 6x. Okay, this is your answer. Then next subdivision, sixth subdivision, and second sum, last subdivision. Okay, the question is a square plus 1 by a square minus 18. Okay, a square plus 1 by a square minus 18. Already we did this, like this sums is a fourth subdivision. Okay, so the same way here also we are going to use. Okay, we know that my 18 is not a square, so we have to make it as a square. So what is the nearest square number? Nearest square number 16 and 25. 25 we are not able to choose, because here already I told you the same way, it is a form, if you want to make it as a form of a minus b whole square, means it can be written as a square plus b square minus 2ab. So in this, here we need 2. So if you take it as 25, we need add to 7, plus 7 and minus 7. Okay, but we have only 2. So I can choose that square, nearest square number as 16. Okay, are you clear? Then you can take it as a square plus 1 by a square then one by a square, then minus 18 plus 2 and minus 2. Already I told you the reason why you are taking plus 2 and minus 2, it will be 0. If you are adding 0, the expression will not change. For that only we are taking the same term in plus and minus also, okay. So you will get a square plus 1 by a square, okay. If you add minus 18 plus 2, minus 18 plus 2, you will get minus 16, then minus 2, okay. It can be written as a square plus 1 by a square minus 2, then minus 16. I can take it this 2 here front side, okay. Why means we want to make it as a whole square formula, okay. So it is in the form of, already I told you, a minus b whole square formula. Here a is equal to a, here a is equal to a and b is equal to 1 by a, okay. So if you apply a minus b whole square, what do you get? A square plus 1 by a square minus 2ab. So minus 2 into a into 1 by a, okay. Plus this numerator and denominator will be cancelled. So you will get a square plus 1 by a square minus 2, okay. So this is the a, here a minus b, okay. Here b is equal to 1 by a. So that is a minus 1 by a the whole square, okay. So you can take it, write as a minus 1 by a whole square. Then we know that 16 is a square number of 4. 4 square is 16. So 4 square, okay. So again the same format, okay. So this is the form of a square minus b square. So again you can write as a plus b into a minus b. So here a is 1, a minus 1 by a. So a minus 1 by a plus 4 and a minus 1 by a minus 4, okay. That's all. This is your answer. Thank you, students.